SST's virtual reality virtual tour, filmed in 360 camera. I'm your friend and humble host, Abel DeLeon, Director of Marketing and Communications here at SST, and it's my honor to take you on this virtual reality tour. Right now, you should be able to drag your screen in order to follow me around. As I walk around the room, you'll be able to either drag your screen or turn your head if you're wearing virtual reality goggles. And because of the 360 microphone we're using, you should be able to hear me coming more out of the left or right, depending on where I am from your perspective. It's promising to be an exciting tour, and it wouldn't be a School of Science and Technology tour without virtual reality. Follow me. Classroom. Now these pre-K classrooms are extra special because our teachers work hard every month to completely strip down the walls and put up completely new decorations. In pre-K, the classroom is the curriculum, and kids learn by exploring and through purposeful play right here in this classroom. Right now these kiddos are learning about farming. Now let's see what this umpire thinks about SST. It's good! Well, that's great to know, Mr. Umpire. Now here we are with some of our littlest learners in kindergarten. Now you can see that even though we're in kindergarten, our kids are already utilizing those iPads and starting to learn about 21st century knowledge and skills that will empower them for the rest of their life to pursue their dreams. Plus, it's a lot of fun too, isn't it, guys?
Yeah!
I knew they'd agree, and we hope you will too. Well, here we are in a first grade classroom. Now, if you look around by either dragging your screen if you're on a computer, or by simply looking left to right if you're wearing virtual reality goggles right now, you'll be able to look around this room. You're gonna see things like the math wall, which are a staple of every SST classroom. We're also gonna see the word wall back here. And in that corner, a lot of teacher resources, including Rigby and other leveled readers and things like that. Now, a big important thing in every first grade classroom is the kidney table. Why? Because the kidney table is where our teachers work closely and individually with students, providing them that one-to-one, face-to-face interaction that really defines what we do here at SST. And welcome to an SST second grade classroom. In here, you're gonna see some of the things that you saw in the first grade classroom, like the math and the word wall, language arts now. We've also got cubbies inside our classrooms so that our kids can store their belongings, lunches, in a safe place that's right here in the classroom. You're also gonna see resources, and you're gonna notice that there's things just all over the walls, making the environment rich with all kinds of rich texts and information for the kids to absorb. Second grade class, everybody. Now remember, you can look around by either turning your head left and right with virtual reality goggles or by clicking on your screen and dragging it to rotate around and see the whole classroom. And now welcome to an SST third grade classroom. Now, third grade is a bit of a departure because the third grade is the first grade in which SST departmentalizes. That means that students in the third grade are being taught by teachers who teach English and social studies or math and science. We do this so that students can start working with teachers that are subject level experts as early as third grade, so that we can really get to that high level rigor and make sure that our students are empowered with the knowledge and skills they'll need to take the high pay, high prestige jobs of tomorrow and chase down their dreams, no matter how big and bold those dreams may be. Now, if you look around this room by dragging your screen or by looking around with virtual reality goggles, you'll see the math word wall and you'll see all kinds of visual aids. You're also seeing student work posted on the walls. That's important to us. As a project-based learning school, it's important that students receive credit and accolades for the product that they produce because it shows them that knowledge is power, the power to make the world a better place, and not tomorrow, but today. It starts here at SST. Let's go look at a third grade ELA classroom. and welcome to the other side of third grade. Now we're in an ELA and social studies classroom. You see that while the walls are still decorated with all kinds of visual aids and helpful tools and reminders for students, as well as demonstrating student work, this room is all about the literary and historic perspective. And it really gives our children the ability to dive deep into all of the subjects, starting here in the third grade. Remember, you can look around this room by dragging that screen or turning your head with the virtual reality goggles. And now welcome to a fourth grade SST math classroom. Now, if you look around by dragging your screen or looking around with virtual goggles, you'll see a lot of things that are common to all of the grades here at SST, including the smart projector, the student work up on the walls, as well as plenty of visual aids to provide that context and content-rich learning environment that's been shown in studies to support kids in learning at the highest levels. And that's what we're all about here at SST, to provide students with a level of educational rigor that will prepare them for whatever their dreams may be. Now we're in an SST library. This is a place where kids can check out books that are in line with their interests and find things that they're interested in by taking an adventure in a book. It's also a great place for them to pick up research literature in order to write research papers and do other projects. Look around by scrolling on your screen. Now, this particular library is just getting started, as this is a new campus, but soon we'll have every bookshelf spilling over with great books for our kids. And welcome to another very special room. This is our reading and resource intervention room. When students at SST begin to struggle, we don't let them struggle long because we take quick action by enrolling them in our intervention program. In this room, students will receive one-on-one individualized support and assistance to make sure that they can grasp and master all of the important essential knowledge and skills that we teach here in Texas. Well, we wouldn't want you to leave the tour without saying, that sure was a colorful tour of SST. And in that vein, here we are in SST's art room. In here, kids are encouraged to get creative and stretch their artistic muscles. We know that a well-rounded education involves the arts, and that's why we say we're a STEM school, but really, we're picking up steam here at SST. And what tour of SST would be complete without looking at one of the three computer labs in the building? This is the downstairs computer lab, and it's exclusively used by the younger grades. If you look around, you see we've got enough computers and laptops for everyone in the class to have their own, because we start teaching computer coding in kindergarten. We want our kids to grow up to be not just digital natives, but coding natives who understand about 3D animation, digital art, video game design. All of those things will come to them naturally because they were introduced to those knowledge and skills so soon. Here we are inside our medical aid's office. Every SST campus has a medical aid on staff full time. Should any child ever be injured, fall ill, or just have a tummy ache, for example, our medical aid is going to make sure that they are feeling better in no time and that parents are informed so they can be full partners in protecting their child's health and safety. Did you know that SST is a public charter school? And as such, it means that we provide all of the special services that any public school must. Things like special education, gifted and talented program, English as a second language or ESL. All of those programs are part of the SST offering, and we've got special rooms all around the campus to facilitate that kind of support for our students. Now, here we have an example of how SST does restrooms. Now, you'll notice that outside the restrooms, we've got water fountains with water bottle fillers, That's a great way to make sure that our kids are safe and healthy and not exposed to unnecessary germs. You're also going to notice that we don't have doors on the restrooms. Instead, we built them airport style so that the children can have privacy, while at the same time, we can keep a watchful ear on them, so to speak, to make sure that nothing is happening in those restrooms that we wouldn't want happening. And now here we are in the cafeteria. Take a look around. Now, if you look straight up, you're going to see that we've got some exposed ducting up above the ceiling tiles. Now, that's because we're a STEM-based school, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. And it's important for us that even the building be a visual aid to help kids understand the technology that's behind the scenes. And welcome to SST's Gymnasium. You can follow me by dragging your screen or by turning your head with virtual reality goggles. Look at the scale and grandeur of this gym. This gym allows us to play in the competitive sports leagues that we do. You know, a lot of people believe that charter schools don't have competitive sports. That's simply not true. We compete in the Texas Charter Leagues. We compete against other charter schools. And our schools have done very well if you've been following our progress. SST schools have basketball teams, volleyball teams, soccer teams, cross-country teams, and different campuses have even more teams than that. We believe that a well-rounded student should have the arts and physical activity so that they can grow up to be purpose-driven, happy, and healthy. That's what we're doing here at SST. We are all about fun. And that's why, out here on the playground, we've got not one, but two playgrounds for our kiddos to play on. In addition, you're gonna see we've got the basketball courts, we've got the soccer fields over there, partially obscured, but if you'll allow me to move our camera slightly, you'll see the field that we use for PE, sports, soccer, all kinds of great things. Directly behind me, you're gonna see the other playground, and to my side, another playground here. Pardon our noise in here, but we're now in one of the most exciting rooms in SST school. It's our makerspace. It's a near 3,000 square foot space where kids have access to all of the latest 21st century equipment to make projects, to go along with our project-based learning format. Now, behind me, you're gonna see that we've got the rooms walled off with glass walls that only the teacher can open. That's so that kids can only access the tools and equipment in these rooms when they're supposed to. A lot of times, kids are working on Project Lead the Way, like these kiddos in here today. In Project Lead the Way, kids are able to earn high school credit in middle school and college credit in high school. You'll also see, if you look back in this region, that we've got a whole lot of PLTW kits, as well as robotics kits, VEX kits, and all kinds of other great stuff for our kids to expand their knowledge and horizons, because we know that a better education leads to a better future. SST strives to empower our children to become ethical world citizens. Now, even though math is the universal language, they say, it's still not a complete replacement for actual foreign languages. And that's why at SST, we always offer at least Spanish and Turkish as options for foreign languages. However, some of our campuses offer an even wider array, including languages like Python, a computer coding language. But here we are in the Lote Room, as we call it here at SST, which stands for Languages Other Than English. And welcome to another of the three computer labs here at SST. In this computer lab, kids work on computer coding and all kinds of great things. One of the great programs that we utilize is the FUSE program, which was developed by Northwestern University. In this program, kids are introduced to 26 or 28 modules at different levels of rigor that introduce them to the biggest knowledge and skills that are going to be needed in the 21st century. Things like 3D printing, computer coding. Follow me by dragging your screen. You'll see if you look down this way that the entire room is completely surrounded with computers and has not one but two 3D printers inside it, so that our kids all have access to those 3D printers to print the things that they design. They design things using CAD-type software and are then able to actually print that out and take it home. That's an important part of project-based learning, is making sure that there's an actual product associated with what they're doing. Right now, by looking at the board, we'll see that this class is working on Game Designer, Beats Builder, and Dream Home. That's really cool because Game Designer is for our kids that want to learn to build their own video games. So they're in there making, improving, and fixing video game bugs so that they can learn to be video game designers. Beats Builder is another really cool program that's part of Fuse, where the kids can make their own music, beats, and even ringtones, which they can port out to their own phones. And of course, Dream Home is a great program for our future architects, where they get to sketch up, design, and create their own dream home. And they're only limited by their imagination, which can be true of almost anything when you put your mind to it. And now welcome to an SST 5th grade social studies classroom. Just like in the other classrooms, you're going to notice that the walls are decorated with a plethora of different visual aids, as well as examples of student work and things, because that project-based learning requires us to make sure the kids get accolades for the work that they do. Now you'll also notice that the kids in this class are also working on Chromebooks and developing those 21st century knowledge and skills. At SST, every student has either a Chromebook or an iPad to help them along in their educational journey. Remember, you can look around this room by scrolling on your screen or just looking left or right if you're wearing virtual reality goggles. And here we are inside an SST 6th grade classroom. You can see the uniforms have now changed to a different color, and the kiddos are working on Chromebooks instead of iPads. This is important for us as School of Science and Technology because we believe that children having the knowledge and skills to operate 21st century equipment is what's going to provide them the high-pay, high-prestige jobs of tomorrow and allow them to chase down those dreams that we know we're here to support them in. And plus, we're having a lot of fun along the way, aren't we, guys?
Yeah!
I thought they'd agree, and we hope you do too. Now, we're all about safety first at SST schools, and that's why all of our schools come equipped with a dual manual locked door that prevents any unauthorized intruders or visitors from entering the building. Let's see it in action. The first thing that we have to do to enter the building is to buzz our way in where there's a camera. We hear it ringing. Hey, it's Angel De Leon here to visit School of Science and Technology. Now, if they deem that I'm someone that is able to enter, they'll hit the button and the door will unlock. Now, as we go in, all visitors have to sign in at the front office. Hello! Yeah, I'm happy to be signing in. I appreciate it. Now, once we've signed in and given our ID to get a name tag, we're able to be buzzed in again. Did you hear that? The second magnet locked door. Follow me. Now, once we enter this first lobby, you're able to look around and see that we take safety seriously. From the fire extinguisher, to the AED machine, and the defibrillator over here, to the bleed control kit, we've got everything that our school needs to stay safe right here at arm's reach at School of Science and Technology.